Hey my little rays of sunshine, welcome back to the YouTube channel, and today I'm going to be doing realism. Yes, I am doing realism. Alright, so my art style has some kind of realism in it. I do semi-realistic art style, but I wanted to try something more realistic and like fully realistic. So I challenged myself today and I looked up a reference for colorful art. Colorful portraits on Pinterest, because if you look at my art pieces, like they're just, the skin is just brown, like just browns and tans, which is boring. I need to spice up my portraits with some color in the skin. So I looked at some colorful portraits on Pinterest and I was like, let's get it. So that's two challenges in one: realism digitally and colorful skin. So I don't put color on skin because I get scared. I feel like they're gonna look like alien, they're not gonna look human, and it just like my brain can't really wrap itself around that concept. Right. But you know, today I've decided to push my brain beyond what it understood as skin, and you know, to do some lighting, do some color. And I hear talking and biting my words and whatever, but y'all get what I'm saying, right? Y'all get what I'm saying. And I'm so excited. I'm proud of how this came out. Of course, obviously, if I practice, I'll get better and better. But for a first attempt, I think this was excellent. I think this was great. I am proud of myself. And as long as I'm proud, that's what matters. You can give me some constructive criticism because that is what helps me to grow. So if you have any tips about digital art, if you have any tips on realism, whatever, I will take it, right? Because that's how you grow, that's how you get better. So anyways, I am proud of this one. I had a bit of issues trying to capture her likeness, but outside of that, I think that I did really good with the rendering of the skin and so on and so forth. And maybe I'll try it again sometime. I'm not sure if I will do it anytime soon. Maybe, maybe not. But it was a really good challenge and I proved to myself that I could actually get it done to a decent point. And yeah, so what I gathered from this whole experience is there are certain parts of the eye that I would like to incorporate into my art style a bit more and make it look better, and skin rendering and all that. So when you do realism, is a really good foundation for how you're going to do your art style, because then you get to translate some of those aspects of realism into your stylized art and it looks better. It looks, even though it's not realistic, it's realistic in concept. So it's good to do realism. It's always good to have a foundation in realism, so that when you go to stylize, things are still proportionate, even though you're stretching proportions and stuff like that, it is still proportionate, and etc, etc, etc. I followed some tips while I was doing this piece, some tips that a lot of artists are saying in painting, especially in the hair. Do not do hair like strands. Don't get lines and just do shoot. No, do it with shapes. So just get a broad brush and just coloring some random strokes, but not too random. At least know what you want the hair to look like, obviously, but like kind of random strokes and blend it out with, I usually blend it out with the round brush because it helps maintain the stroke while still blending it out, rather than an airbrush that just like, you guys know what airbrush does. I hope, because I can't even find the way that I explain it, but I hope y'all get what I'm saying. So yeah, and another challenge in this that I didn't mentally decide to do, but I did, was messy hair. That's something I always used to run from as well. I was always like, how do I figure out the directions of where this hair is going? This is so messy, like going all sorts of directions and stuff like that. But again, once you follow the fundamentals, do the big hair shape, do the main shape, and then you could block in your shading, and then you could add extra strands to show the messiness of the hair. So yeah, anyways, this was a good experience. It took long, but I don't mind, honestly, because once you're enjoying yourself, like, time passes and you don't realize. But it was a really fun experience, and yes, I know it looks weird that her shoulders cut off. I was sticking to the reference and I couldn't really imagine what the rest of her shoulder looked like, so that was weird. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Keep smiling and choose happiness. Thank you.